Senior center Matt Stainbrook here with freshman guard Trevon Bluiett. First off, Trevon, thanks for being with us.
Oh, thank you for having me.
No problem. Let's start it off with, first, who do you compare your game to most? If there's one player that you think you play like, who would that be?
I would probably say I play more like a Paul Pierce, only because he's not very quick, and we all know that I'm not quick, but somehow we get to point A to point B. So, you know, that's what a lot of people say. That's who I play like. So now I'm just going to go and say that I play like him.
I can definitely see you, you know, modeling your game after a 40-year-old Paul Pierce, definitely. So you've been playing basketball for a long time now. Throughout your whole career from when you started as a young kid to now, what do you think is your favorite basketball moment?
I would say my favorite basketball moment by far would be winning a state championship for the first time in school history my freshman year. I don't think there was any moment that, you know, could top that.
Definitely. It makes a lot of sense. So you ended up choosing Xavier. I know you were recruited by a lot of different schools. Is there any specific things that maybe, you know, brought you to Xavier? What made you decide to come to Xavier?
Probably just the relationship that I had with the coaching staff. You know, I've been having a good relationship with them since about freshman year. So I think that's kind of what pulled it over. And, you know, along with, you know, where Xavier basketball was headed, you know, and then the players that they brought in and the brothership that they had, I think that that was something that other schools didn't have.
Gotcha. Now, coming from Park Tudor, you maybe necessarily didn't travel a ton. And when you did, probably by bus. And your first trip as a Xavier Musketeer was to Brazil. Did you have any favorite part of the Brazil trip, or did it sort of, you know, open your eyes to how we travel and how things are a little bit different from the high school level?
Yeah, definitely. I think that 9-hour flight was definitely interesting. I don't like planes at all, so, you know, I definitely didn't like flying in 9 hours at that. It was very uncomfortable. But, you know, overall, it was a good trip, you know, being able to go to the other side of the country and see, you know, different types of cultures and stuff. I thought that was pretty magnificent.
Definitely. You also mentioned that you like SpongeBob SquarePants. Do you have any information on the lowdown on that?
I mean, I've grown up watching SpongeBob, you know, and then, you know, I thought around the age of 14, I might start getting into ESPN and stuff like that. But, you know, SpongeBob kept coming on and they kept coming with new episodes, so, you know, I couldn't just stop after watching, you know, the old ones. So,
favorite episode.
Off the top of your head, favorite character, go.
Patrick.
Makes sense. I could definitely see you with the Patrick kind of guy. You also mentioned that, you know, later in life you maybe want to be a sports anchor or a journalist. Who is your favorite sports anchor?
My favorite sports anchor is probably by far Dick Vitale. And that's just because every game I watch, he's always the one commentating. And, you know, he jokes around a lot sometimes. And he knows a lot about basketball. So that's probably my favorite one.
Last question for you. Your middle name is Nike. What's the story behind that?
I never asked about that story until I got older. But, you know, I thought it was cool that my middle name was Nike because it was a coincidence that my favorite shoe brand or clothing brand was Nike. But I asked him later on what was the significance about that, and he said that in Greek, Nike means victorious. So, you know, that's kind of where he got that name from.
And we're looking for a lot of victory this season. Freshman guard Trevon Bluiett.